the only outsourced factor that contributes to the entire coral structure well-being is the lights. So today is the part 2 of Master SPS Reef Tank series, and this is lights. SPS reef keeping requires strong lighting in terms of spectrum, wattage, and power levels. There are a few types of lights that provides SPS corals a full coral group benefits, such as these LED lights, or metal halides, or T5 light types. Or you can mix it up together like a hybrid system, where three types of lights merge together to work out for a single tank. For SPS reef keeping, you must follow a 24-hour cycle light schedule, just like a ramp up time for in the morning and ramp down time for in the evening. Okay, don't suggest you guys to put up your lights more than 12 hours. And please limit your lights schedule just below 12 hours schedule timing, okay? 12 hours, and that's the maximum you can go. If you wanted to go higher than that, I don't know about you guys, you can contribute to algae growth onto your rock works and also on your glasses, okay? Following a 24-hour cycles provides a very natural sunlight effect, just like in the nature, and also don't stress out your corals and the polyps and also inhabitants inside your reef tank. Mastering your SPS reef tank lighting is easy as long as you don't have a strong constant lighting and you follow your 24-hour cycle, and also you have a blanketing effect just like the T5 lights provide. That's why you can see all those T5 people have a tremendous amount of growth in your coral polyps, and also these skeletons are growing up much quicker than compared to the LEDs. LEDs are straightforward lights which has a spotlight effects rather than compared to metal halides and also T5s. So combining both lights such as these LEDs and also metal halides or even T5s can be a factor in helping out your corals growth, and also to limiting factor where it don't create any STNs or RTN into your coral polyps. The only thing that be troubling for new reefers, for SPS corals especially with LED lightings, is that you need to constantly adjust your lighting and also your level of intensity of the light paths, okay? So in this way you don't know whether you are providing a full spectrum or enough power level for your SPS keeping. So by using these metal halides and T5s, which is just the plug and play type instead of like LEDs, this can be just instantly can be set it out like that and let them grow out just like signature. So with the last week's topic of flow, and today we're covering up the lights and everything about else, these two subjects are the most important for your SPS reef keeping. The good flow and also the good lights provided, you can have a good SPS coral growth just like any other advanced reefers, okay? So if you guys are having to do with the DIY lightings, I figured out you must have a high wattage rated onto your LEDs, so then you can at least you can see a coral growth, or else you guys can go ahead and buy the suppliers provided LED lightings or these metal halides or the T5 lights, which can be just plug and play, and then you can get the instant growth onto your corals. So now you see is the evening REM down time on my reef tank, so that's why you can see one of my metal halides is off. Another one I just turned it on just to shoot this video. So guys, that's about it for this week's topic, lights on mastering your SPS reef keeping. So I hope you guys had a clue and an idea how to keep your SPS tank. Okay, the most important thing is that flow and your lighting. So for the next week's episode, I'll finish up this three-part series with the last part for the next week. Until then guys, please don't forget to subscribe and also please leave a like. Guys, that's all for this week, and please be safe wherever you guys are, and happy reef keeping.